So first off, this video has spoilers. It is intended for people who have seen Episode 7, The Force Awakens, or people who do not mind spoilers, because we're going to be talking about Episode 8, which I have to say, even though I had my problems with Episode 7, I am extremely excited for. I think they did a very good job setting up a number of things for Episode 8, and there are a couple of things that, if they're fixed, would be great for Episode 8. So that's what we're going to be discussing today, because usually when I make this type of video, I give my suggestions for what should happen next in the franchise. However, in this case, I think that Rian Johnson's marching orders are pretty clear. I think the framework has definitely been set in motion. I mean, he can add some flourishes, as I'm going to suggest, but I think overall, we know what's going to happen over the rest of this sequel trilogy. They've set the stage, right? Luke is going to train Rey. We're going to find out why Rey was abandoned on Jakku and who she really is. We're going to find out who this Snoke dude is. We're going to defeat the First Order because evil always loses. And then, I think this is the highest priority, we're going to avenge Han Solo. But I think more likely, even though that's what I think the highest priority is, I think we're going to save Ben Solo's soul. All right, so again, this is what I think that Rian Johnson should layer onto that to make it awesome. I'm very, very excited about Episode 8, particularly Daisy Ridley's Rey. But we're going to start out with, I think, Rian Johnson's biggest problem, and that's that he needs to fix Kylo Ren. Because who's going to forgive Kylo Ren for killing Han Solo? I'm sure even Adam Driver, probably before they filmed, was like on his hands and knees in J.J. Abrams's, that sounds horrible, in his trailer, being saying, oh, please, please don't make me kill Han Solo. Maybe he could accidentally trip over my foot or something, or my robes, and he would plummet to his death. Please don't make him die by my hand. I would like to have a career after this. And JJ's like, no, no, you signed the contract. This is what's going to happen. Your career is not that big yet. You have to do what I say. You're not Harrison Ford. You can't just opt out of this franchise and I have to go along with it. Get out there and kill him. It's a mercy killing. At least feel good about that, Adam Driver. He doesn't want to be here anymore. So anyway, they have to fix this. They have to make people like Kylo Ren, because obviously the game plan is to make him an anti-hero, you know, to make Kylo Ren somebody that everybody's rooting for to be redeemed. And I was there until he killed Han Solo, because I think that Adam Driver did a very good job setting that up. I thought, for instance, there was a lot of, and I hope they're not, I was like, is this another incestuous twin situation? Because I thought there were some pretty sexy vibes in that interrogation with Daisy Ridley's Rey. I was like, I could see a lot of people swooning over Kylo Ren. I am on the edge of swooning over Kylo Ren. Maybe I actually am swooning over Kylo Ren. But he dumped a bucket of cold water on that boy when he killed Han Solo. But I saw a glimpse of what the character could be. So I'm like, can we get back to that somehow? I also liked the idea that he's just so powerful. You saw that when he froze that shot at the beginning of the movie from Poe Dameron. That was so cool. I was like, wow, this guy is major. And even Han Solo told his son, he said, look, Snoke's just using you, man. He just wants your power. And I was like, how powerful are you? This is very interesting. Why are you so dumb, Han Solo? He's clearly going to kill you. But anyway, I think that Kylo Ren's power and sexiness really make the character interesting. And also the fact that he is someone who's torn between the light and the darkness, right? I mean, this, as the Skywalker's family has been, right? I mean, we've seen one person go toward the light, one go toward the dark. Now we can see someone who's torn in the middle. I think it makes perfect sense, but he seems to be really on the side of the dark after having, I mean, he said he needed to go to one side, and he certainly did that. But while Kylo Ren needs to go to one side, the movie, the franchise, needs him to stay in the middle. So I think that's the first thing that Rian Johnson has to do, fix Kylo Ren. And I'm wondering if he even can be fixed. So I would like to know down below, do you think Kylo Ren can be redeemed? And if so, how can it be done? So that's the first order of business. Save Adam Driver's career. Next, turn Poe Dameron into the new Han Solo. We have a job opening! And I think Poe Dameron fits the role just fine. In fact, as I said in my spoiler review, I think Poe Dameron's sole purpose for existing is to be the new Han Solo. And that's why he's sidelined quite a bit in this first you know, installment of the sequel trilogy because they needed to get Han Solo out of the way. But he's got the hair, he has the partialness to leather jackets, he's a good pilot, right? But I think what's different from him and Han Solo is, you know, Han Solo is a bit of a jokester, but Finn's taking care of the jokes, and we'll get to him too. But I think that Poe Dameron is a little bit more of a cool customer. You know, I think I like the fact, as I said in my spoiler review, that he's so competent. He's so sure of himself. He's so on the ball. It was just really neat to see. And I think Oscar Isaac gave the character not only a great sense of purpose, but also he was just such a good actor. I was really impressed with the little bit of acting he was allowed to do in The Force Awakens. So I'm very excited to see what he could maybe bring to the franchise when he gets to step into his role finally as the new Han Solo. So I think that's going to be great. I mean, he's already set up to join the group of, you know, our pseudo, our new Luke Skywalker and new Princess Leia. Sorry, Finn, I'm afraid you are the new Princess Leia of the group. I will explain that momentarily. But he's got the in with BB-8, and he already knows Finn. So all he's got to do is win over Rey, and I think he can do it because he seems like the charmer. All right, so also, by the way, I have in my notes here, Poe Dameron's parents actually served with Han Solo. That's something that's going on in the Marvel comics right now, the Marvel Star Wars comics. So maybe he'll, like, that'll be his intro to the group. He's like, my parents knew Han Solo. Hey, is anyone sitting here? And they're like, no, we're keeping it warm for you, Poe. So I think he can step into that role easily and perhaps, you know, rescue this franchise from the loss of Han Solo. All right, next. Use Luke Skywalker. I was a little upset they didn't use him in this movie. I think Rian Johnson has to make up for that. He has to make up for lost Luke Skywalker time, especially because, you know, the opening credits sequence was like, everyone's looking for Luke Skywalker. And I was like, oh, I'm so excited to see Luke Skywalker. And then as the movie went on, I was like, it's getting close to the end. Where's Luke Skywalker? And sure enough, he was just like a stick, you know, he just stuck him on at the end of the movie. And they were like, come back for episode 8. And I was like, okay, I will. But as I said, Rian Johnson has to use him, especially because I think everybody feels a little cheated that they didn't get any Luke Skywalker in Force Awakens. So, my first question for Luke Skywalker that I think that Rian Johnson needs to answer is, does he feel bad that he did not rescue Ben Solo from the dark side, that he didn't clean up his mess when Ben Solo killed all of his Jedi students, and then, because Luke Skywalker ran away, Ben Solo went on to kill his old friend, and I guess his romantic rival, but that was his sister, so it doesn't count, Han Solo. I'd be like, yeah, I bet you feel real bad, Luke, because you ran away. Han's dead. And Luke's like, but now I can assume my rightful place as the coolest person in the franchise. And then Poe Dameron jumps in and he's like, and Luke's like, damn it. But anyway, so I think that's the first thing that needs to be addressed. The second is he the new Yoda? You know, they're being very derivative of the original trilogy here. So it would seem that this is now the training montage. Just like, you know, Luke went and found Yoda and trained with him, Daisy has found Luke Skywalker and will now train, Rey, Daisy Ridley playing Rey. She will train with Luke Skywalker and we'll have basically a redux of those scenes. I can understand that maybe the movie would go that way and, you know, the sequel episode 8, and I think that it would be in line with what's happened in episode 7. But I would like to see Rian Johnson show that Luke Skywalker trains his students in a different way than Yoda. He's come up with his own system. Like, he's like, I use the mixed sentences because that really worked for me, and so I just, you know, I just repeat Yoda. And also, we all know that Mark Hamill does very good impressions and voice work, so he could do it if he wanted to. But I would be very curious just to compare the two training methods, and I am excited to spend more time on Skellig Michael Island, where we, you know, find Luke Skywalker at the end of Episode 7. That is an amazing location. It's just like a gift from the location gods. It's like New Zealand was to the Lord of the Rings franchise. You're like, it's just growing here, or it's already been made. I didn't have to touch it. I just stuck Daisy Ridley and Mark Hamill in there, and it was amazing. So I thought that was great. So I want to see more of that. Also, just don't forget that Luke Skywalker was supposed to not only be like the last Jedi, but like a really powerful Jedi. And I think that we shouldn't cheat Mark Hamill out of the opportunity to show what he can do. Now, speaking of powerful Jedi, that's my number 4. I want to see Rey, Omega level mutant. I'm sorry, Jedi. But that's kind of the feeling that I was getting from her in Episode 7, and it was super exciting. I love Daisy Ridley in this movie. I'm now a huge Daisy Ridley / Rey fan, and I'm very excited to see where they take this character, because she's already so powerful. I hope she's not, Kylo Ren's sister, by the way. They're both super powerful. I'm like, again, as I said, more twins. But I would like her not to be a Skywalker. They already have their Skywalker to be the focus of the sequel trilogy, and that's Ben Solo, because he's Leia's son. And I would like, you know, not all the Jedi have to come from the Skywalker bloodline. I would like somebody else to, you know, another, you know, the idea that, you know, because that's the whole idea of the Joseph Campbell situation that made Star Wars so popular to begin with, that anyone could discover they're the hero of the story. But they ruin that if it's only Skywalkers, right? So I would love Rey to be some other character, and that the mystery of how she got to Jakku has nothing to do with the Skywalkers or the Solos or anyone we've met before. She's a new character from a new background who's come in contact with our existing bloodlines. That's what I would ideally like. Now, I think she's already doing very cool stuff in the episode 7, and I thought that Daisy Ridley did a wonderful job selling that. Like when she was using her mind control powers and using, you know, her ability to use the Force to pull that lightsaber towards her. I think Daisy Ridley did such a good job with that. I want to see her be able to do more. So they said that she's going to get even better, so let's amp her up. I want to see her be a badass Jedi. And also, I think that what's also great about the character of Rey is that she's obviously also very clever and a great strategist. So if you put that with her power, her, you know, her raw power, she could be an amazing character. Oh, by the way, on a side note, I forgot to mention this in my spoiler review, so this is a spoiler episode. How wasted were the guys from the raid? I was like, why would you hire the guys from the raid to be glorified extras and not fight anybody? That's so silly. So hopefully one or both of them survived and we can meet them later on. But anyway, again, Rey, Omega level mutant. I think we all want to see it. And so then finally, the fifth thing that I want to see Rian Johnson do with episode 8 is that he needs to anchor Finn. Why is Finn there? I mean, as I said, he's the Princess Leia of our redux of the original trio, right? And he is kind of, they do set up the love triangle a little bit. He likes Rey, but there's some chemistry with him and Poe, as some people are already saying at the beginning of the movie. So that's my little hee-hee. But I mean, in all seriousness, he does seem to be there only to be the love interest of Rey, and also to be the heart of the group. But that's kind of like makes some Star Wars PETA, and I think that John Boyega deserves better than that, and I think he can deliver a unique character. So I would like to see him, you know, I don't know, maybe Poe Dameron is a pilot, he likes his solo missions, so maybe Finn's future is to go from being a stormtrooper, a faceless soldier in the ranks, to being a leader, because he has heart, and he knows what the right thing to do is. And that would also make him a little bit like Leia, though. She, of course, became a huge leader of the Resistance and a general. But I think that Finn just needs to have more of a reason to be there besides just being a good friend and a love interest for Rey. They do scream after each other a lot, like Katniss and Peeta too, don't they, though, when you think about it? But I would like to see him have, like, a character arc to explore his past. He said he also came from a family that he was, you know, torn from. Maybe he's going to go find them. I just need Finn to have his own path as well, instead of just being there basically to support Rey. I think that would be really nice for the character, and I think that the people who are excited to see a black actor in Star Wars would appreciate it as well, to make him a character in his own right. But, you know, there's all the rumors about how episode 8 is shaking up, and that there are going to be other, you know, actors added, and he's reading with them, so that seems to hint that, you know, Rian Johnson is doing that. So those are the five things that I want to see Rian Johnson achieve with episode 8. I'm curious to hear your lists down below. Thank you so much for tuning in, and you can check out some other episodes right now.